mathematicians, it's Justin again, and welcome back to the planet Numeria, where we've been exploring so many cool features while practicing our place value skills. Today, we'll get the chance to observe some alien butterfly species. Hey, check it out! There are about 350,000 different kinds of butterflies on this planet, right? Technically, there are 351,934, but 350,000 is an easier number to work with, and it's really close to the actual amount. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to round a number to any place up to the millions. Additionally, you'll be able to determine the largest or smallest number that will round to a benchmark number. Have your guided notes ready, and let's round where the alien butterflies are found. Wow, these butterflies are so beautiful. The patterns and colors are all unique. There are so many, it would take ages to count all of them. I bet we can get close though by making an estimate. Would 5 be a good estimate for the number of butterflies here? No, there's way more than that. An estimate is a logical guess that is close to the actual answer or number. One way to make an estimate is by rounding the numbers or adjusting a number to a nearby value to make it easier to work with. Here's an example. There are 46,829 red butterflies. If we were to round to the nearest 10,000, what should we do first? We'll start by identifying the digit in the place value we're rounding to, which in this case is the 10,000s place. Since there is a 4 in the 10,000s place, that means this will either round to 40,000 or to 50,000. But how do we know which amount it's closer to? We need to check the place value to the right. That digit will give us the most useful information since it has the next largest value in the number. That 6 in the thousands place means that 46,829 is closer to 50,000 than it is to 40,000. So if the digit in the place to the right is a 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, it will cause the number to round up, because it's closer to that greater amount. But what do we do with the digits that are less than the halfway point, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0? How do they round? They're closer to the starting value, which means the number would stay the same. Numbers can be rounded to any place value. For a more specific estimate, let's round 46,829 to the nearest 100. Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. To round to the hundreds place, we need to check the digit to the right of it, so the tens place. The digit 2 has a value of 20, which means 46,820 is closer to 46,800 than it is to 46,900. So when we round this to the nearest 100, 46,829 rounds to 46,800. Besides making numbers easier to work with, using rounding to estimate can help us check whether or not our answer is reasonable. I wonder how many green and peach butterflies there are altogether. We can estimate the sum first to know what our answer should be close to. Let's round each number to the nearest 100,000. For the green butterflies, the digit to the right is a 4. Does that mean this number is closer to 200,000 or 300,000? 40,000 isn't quite to the halfway point, so 240,107 rounds to 200,000. Pause the video here to round 371,245 to the nearest 100,000 in your guided notes. The digit to the right of the 100,000 place is a 7, so 371,245 rounds up to 400,000. So there are about 200,000 green butterflies and about 400,000 peach butterflies, or around 600,000 altogether. The actual total is 611,352. Notice how close that is to our estimate? If we had an actual total that was way different, we'd probably want to check our work for any mistakes. We can estimate for any operation too, so we could use this to check multiplication as well. There are 1,986,400 yellow butterflies, and about 2 times as many pink butterflies. What is an easier number to work with that is close to 1,986,400? It's close to 2 million. 2 times as many as 2 million would be 4 million. There are actually 4,110,836 pink butterflies. So is 4 million a reasonable estimate? Yes, it's really close to the actual number of pink butterflies. Another way to estimate is to use benchmark numbers or reference numbers that are easy to work with. This can give us more flexibility with our estimates. Check out these blue butterflies. There are about 500,000 of them. What are some possible values for the actual population of these butterflies that would round to 500,000? Remember that the possibilities can round up from 400 something thousand or down to stay at 500,000. Pause here to record some possible values that will round to 500,000. Any number between 450,000 and 499,999 will round up to 500,000. And any number between 500,000 and 549,999 will round down to 500,000. Why wouldn't a number like 448,000 round to 500,000? Because that 4 in the 10,000s place puts it closer to 400,000. And why doesn't 550,000 round to 500,000? It's all about that digit in the next greatest place value. That 5 means that 550,000 or anything greater will round up to 600,000. So, what have we learned today besides the fact that there are way more alien butterflies than we ever imagined? Well, now you know that numbers can be rounded to any place as a way to estimate. You also know how to identify the largest or smallest number that will round to a benchmark number. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice rounding numbers to the millions place. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time!